We've all been waiting so long for this. Our first look at Episode 8 Star Wars The Last Jedi has finally arrived in the form of a teaser trailer. I was actually preparing my review for Fate of the Furious, but then this trailer dropped and I was like, nope, Star Wars comes first. Sorry, Vin Diesel. But let's go ahead and take a look at this teaser and try to figure out what's going on here. Spoilers for the trailer, obviously, so if you haven't seen it and don't want anything spoiled, come back after you've watched it. So we start out with a shot of Rey, who looks to be undergoing some sort of training with Luke, where she looks like she's in distress for whatever reason. I think she could possibly be having another force vision here like she did in episode 7, or she's just going through some intense physical training that has her overwhelmed. Either way, then we get a bunch of shots of the island where Luke was living in his self-imposed exile, and episode 8 will definitely pick up exactly where 7 left off, on that island with Rey meeting Luke, and then figuring out why he left, what he plans to do next, and so forth, and then they'll obviously begin training. Considering he tells her, quote, breathe, he's obviously trying to teach her to harness the force, and you can see in this shot where all the rocks move around Rey that she's incredibly gifted in the Force. Then we see a shot of, I believe, Leia looking at a map of some sort, and it's difficult to say what this could be, but maybe she's going to head to the island herself to speak with Luke and try to convince him to come back to fight the First Order. Rey then says she sees light and darkness, and we see a shot of Kylo Ren's burnt helmet with smoke coming off of it. Adam Driver has already said that he wears a helmet for a lot of the movie, and the rumor is that it's the same helmet but a newer version with no battle damage and wear. The smoke sort of indicates that a light saber did this damage though, and maybe Kylo did this in a fit of rage like we saw from him in episode 7. That'd be my guess, because he probably ditches the helmet late in this film and tries to be intimidating without it. We then see a shot of what looks like some books. I honestly don't know what those are, but if I had to guess, I bet those are old Jedi training materials from long ago, because I believe that the island they're on was where the original Jedi trained. If I'm wrong on that, feel free to correct me in the comments, but if I had to guess, that's what I think those books are. They're for harnessing the power of the Force and general ideology stuff for training Jedi. Next, we see Rey actually training with a lightsaber on the island, where Luke is going to make her one of the best ever because she already was pretty great in episode 7 with no training whatsoever. And this shot of Finn is interesting because he looks to be in a medical container of some sort, not a Bacta tank or anything, but I'm guessing he'll be recovering for the first act of this film, then jump out of the tube and begin fighting and trying to figure out what's going on in acts 2 and 3. Kylo lit him up pretty badly with the saber in episode 7, so he's probably going to be recovering for a while. Then we see what looks like resistance ships flying towards some opposing AT-ATs, likely from the First Order, and cut to a shot of Poe and BB-8 running towards a ship that eventually explodes inside what looks to be a resistance base. Could there be someone from within the resistance working for the First Order? Once again, hard to say, but that's a plausible theory in my eyes. Next, we see the Millennium Falcon flying and fighting some ships, and I'm honestly curious who's piloting. I'm sure Chewie is co-piloting, but the pilot his or herself would be interesting to know. I'm assuming it's Rey, but it could be Finn too. Then we see two amazing shots. Firstly, Rey running with her saber in her hand, charging towards something, either a battle or just for training purposes, and then Kylo looking extra Sith without his helmet, although the eyes aren't quite there yet, so he obviously hasn't fully immersed himself into the dark side yet. He obviously still feels that pull to the light, which is partly what made him so compelling in episode 7. Next, we see a shot of what looks to be the Jedi Academy massacre, where the Knights of Ren slaughtered all of Luke's disciples, and you can clearly see Luke and R2 in the foreground there. I'm guessing this is a Force vision that Luke shows Rey, where she goes back and watches the events unfold like she did in episode 7, and this will probably be justified for training purposes, but it's mostly for the audience members. And then this next shot, which I believe is not the same event as the Jedi Academy massacre, is a shot of Captain Phasma and her rumored stormtrooper executioners who are reportedly going to follow her around throughout the film. There's artwork out there for these stormtroopers, and I think they do exactly what the name suggests, they execute people. But it would be good to see Captain Phasma be more badass this time around, because her character has some serious potential, and she was seriously underutilized in episode 7. And then we see some spaceships fighting in space, and it's impossible at this point to guess what the context for this battle is, other than that it's Resistance versus First Order, but it looks amazing, and this film is going to be a visual marvel, I'll say that much. And then we hear a voice that sounds like Luke, who says it's time for the Jedi to end. This sounds like Luke truly believes that the Jedi do need to end, and a new, updated, and completely revamped light side force users group needs to be established. I have a feeling that in the earlier point in the trailer where Rey says, quote, a balance is key here, because I think Luke may believe that the Jedi code is outdated, and the gray Jedi like Qui-Gon Jinn, who follow their own path and walk the line sort of between light and darkness, but mostly fall in line with the light, need to be the new order. The Jedi dogma may be too rigid, and Luke may be seeing that Rey needs to start a new order, not Jedi, but something else that can be more fluid and flexible. Also, one other thing I want to note is that throughout this entire trailer, you can hear voices speaking in the background. This sounds like Force ghosts to me, similarly to what Rey experienced from her vision vision in episode 7. This is likely Obi-Wan, Yoda, and even Anakin Skywalker all speaking to Rey and Luke through the Force. I really would love to see a return of Qui-Gon Jinn though as well, and have him drop some knowledge on Rey. But Force Ghost will definitely be a part of episode 8, but I think Hayden Christensen will even come back and speak to Kylo himself, which should be great. So that's it for this trailer analysis and review. It's definitely more of a teaser than a full trailer, and it ultimately didn't show too much, but I loved every second of it. I think we'll get a full trailer sometime in like June maybe, where we see a lot more and more of the plot will be revealed. So did you guys enjoy this Last Jedi teaser? Let me know your thoughts and insights on the trailer in the comments below. What are your theories for episode 8? I just really hope Kylo wears his helmet, because I just paid $560 for this replica helmet, so if he doesn't wear it at least some, I'm gonna be very upset. Either way though, it'll be a great movie and I'm super hyped for it.
That's all for now though. This is WillFoxification signing off. See you in the next review.